What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Frag Nation, and today I have a review for you of Car Mechanic Simulator 2015. This is a simulation game. You've probably seen a ton of them on Steam. Is this one any good? Well, I'm here to tell you that Car Mechanic Simulator, including the free DLC that you get after you purchase the game, does in fact stand up. We're taking a look right now at the quality options. There's not too many there. Granted, there's not a whole lot of graphical prowess to this game. There's not a whole lot of, you know, behind the scenes work. Where this game really shines is in its gameplay and its simplistic nature. Now, Car Mechanic Simulator has these stat pages where you can keep track of everything if you are a mechanic who likes to do that kind of thing or you're interested in those kinds of statistics. But overall, Car Mechanic Simulator does some pretty cool things, and we're going to look at that right now. So the first thing that we're looking at is kind of your office and your garage. So this is where you will spend most of your time in Car Mechanic Simulator, and it's pretty cool. I would have liked it to be a little bigger, maybe accessible more. Here you have the phone where you take different jobs. Granted, they send you these jobs that you can't take for some reason, and I'm not really sure why. And then after you accept a job, it does take a little bit longer to load than I would like. But that's a little nitpicky. For the most part, you'll be using the phone and the computer at a minimalistic pace, as you can only take 4 calls at a time, and the computer becomes irrelevant once you have the tablet to buy your stuff. So you can see the car that we just got here. We sent it over to the lift. It's irrelevant at this point. And we're looking at a car that we're currently working on. So when you receive a car, there'll be certain things wrong with it. And you'll have to figure out exactly what those things are. It could be like replacing the oil or the fuel filter. Some cars will come in with a list of things that need to be done as requested by the owner. And then others you're going to have to figure out for yourself. We'll put this particular car up on the lift. And, you know, just kind of mess around with it. You can see here that there's a ton of, you know, interaction with the car that you can do different parts. And each car has different types of parts. So there's four-wheel drive cars, rear-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, cars with carburetors, cars that run on, you know, pistons, things of that nature, fuel injection, all of that kind of stuff. It's all kind of simulated there. And then you buy the parts that you need to replace in the car via the market. I don't like the way the market is set up. It's a little hard to get some of the products. You're constantly having to check back and forth to see, is this the name of the part that I need? Is this what I actually want? And then once you get it, you know, it's easy to forget how many you have and that kind of stuff. So I wish there was a little bit better way to purchase items and then kind of organize them in your inventory, which we'll look at here in just a second. But you can see here we're changing the oil in the car. It's got you know, an animation for that. And overall, the amount of interactions and the amount of parts in these cars is fairly impressive. It can get confusing at times if you do not do your research and you do not pay attention to the parts you're taking out. You will get lost and you will forget what parts go where. So after changing out the engine oil here, we'll put the car back down and show you the kind of inside checker mode. So when you have the car down, you can, as I said, put oil in it, as you can see here, but you can also use a variety of tools to see what other things are wrong with the car, as not all of them are going to be clearly displayed on the you know, when it's brought in. There's going to be hidden problems that you're going to have to do research as a mechanic to find out. And you see there's a bunch of parts that say part not found. So how do we do that? To do that, we go into the car and we switch it into the observer mode, which shows you the quality of each part on the car. Green being good, yellow being bad, orange being pretty bad, and then red being off the chart. You'll see some familiar mechanic tools like the OBD reader, the compression tool, which allows you to detect compression issues within the car, and then the electric meter, which will show you things that are broken electrically in the car, which this is all pretty nice. It, you know, creates you know, a dynamic to the gameplay. These might not find all of the problems. You might have to take the entire engine block apart to figure out what's wrong with the car, and it could be just one bad part. That's part of the fun of being a mechanic, as any real life mechanic will tell you. So after you do that kind of stuff, If there's still doubt in your mind, you don't really know what's going on, you can head on over to the garage door and go to the map menu. There's three things here currently, the auction and the garage. Once you go to this particular part, this is called the test course. It allows you to test drive these cars. However, the driving in this game is laughable at best. I don't know why they put this particular part in here. This is the very little bit of driving that you can do is on this test course here. And the controls are pretty wonky. The mirrors reflect weird. And it just overall just seems a little bit unnecessary. Maybe an on-rails thing would have been better. But I guess they're trying to give you the freedom, you know, to drive some of the cars in the game, which I can't fault the game for doing that. You'll see after I did that, I found two other, you know, issues with the car. So we're able to put it back up on the lift and work on it some more to try and figure out what's going on with it. So you'll see we're going to start taking apart the car. There's different, you know, bolts and different materials that go to make up these pieces. So it adds that, you know, that extra layer of simulation. You can see here the brakes are all messed up. So you can change out, you know, the brake pads, the rotors, and all of that kind of stuff using your mechanical prowess to, you know, figure out what else is wrong with the car. Not everything comes up on these tests, as I mentioned earlier. One thing I will note, and you're going to see here, is the camera is very, very wonky. I do not like the way that the camera works in this game. It's kind of a free float towards the center of gravity position. So if you click on something, that's going to be your center, and then the camera kind of rotates around that. I would have liked a free roaming camera a little bit better in a game like this, especially one that has so many different parts and sections and weird angles to get at to get these particular things. However, them being highlighted does help. The next thing you're going to see here is the completed job. Once it's done, it will show you the total amount of money that you've earned for the job. And when that's done, you can lower the car and send it out on its way. One of the frustrating things is when you do this, sometimes if you're missing a part, it doesn't necessarily tell you what part is missing. Sometimes, I don't know, other times it does. And then you'll also see here that outside of doing engine work, you can also do body work on the car. I just took off the pieces here. I didn't actually perform any outside body work, but you can take different parts off the car, replace them with different parts, and then you can paint the car in the paint shop, which we'll look at here in just a second. You see the test path there, which you can test other things. That's the paint shop where you can get the car painted. And then you have your toolbox. This is basically your perk system. The more cars that you do, the more points you get, and you can spend those points in these particular talents to either repair items, make things come apart faster, inspect things faster, things like that. And then there's this useless minigame of repairing parts. I wish it just kind of did it automatically for you. But the better you get, you may be able to repair broken parts in the game. And then this is the parking lot, which I didn't get to unlock. It takes a ton of time. I've already put in about 10 to 15 hours into this game and haven't unlocked the parking lot yet. But that really is it for Mechanic Simulator 2015. It's a very cool and unique game. I actually enjoyed it, and this game is going to score a 8 out of 10. It is a great mechanic simulator, probably the best type of simulation game out there right now. I know there's a ton of them. This one has a ton of fun features. I've literally been playing this thing just like nonstop, and I have other games to play. Like, I have a big list of games to review, and I've just been stuck playing this just because it's so fun to be able to, you know, come in here, work on the cars that I don't necessarily get to do in real life. I'm not that technical with cars. I know a little bit, but coming in here and getting to do that kind of thing. And then the other feature, like I said, the garage, which I didn't have a chance to show you just because of how long it takes to unlock. You can actually build your own cars from the ground up, different body parts. You can paint them. You can do all sorts of stuff. And then you can sell those cars for cash on that auction place that I showed you way back in the beginning of the video. But yeah, there's a ton of fun things to do, and it seems like this game's going to have some additional DLC, maybe free, maybe not. Either way, the game company seems really intent on bringing good simulation games to market. Car Mechanic Simulator 2014 and Truck Simulator have all been pretty good games as well. But that's going to do it for us over here at Frag Nation. So thank you guys so much for watching. Car Mechanic Simulator 2015 did a good job. We appreciate that. So we will see you guys next time here on Frag Nation TV.